Hey everybody, it's Tom, WA2IVD. I've been working on several projects over the last month or so. I've got some updates to that ICOM accessory jack interface circuit, and there'll be a video coming out on this soon. And I've been working on this crowbar circuit, which is designed to help protect your radio if you're working on a power supply that may be yours, or maybe you're at a club event or some kind of a contest, and the power supply has some voltage issues. I'll have a video coming out on this also, but I wanted to preempt those because of something I found while I was trying to test this circuit, and I had a little bit of a panic attack because I thought the circuit that I had here was not able to blow the fuse that I put in here. This is designed to take a little mini blade fuse, and I have a box of those here. Some of you may have a kit like this. Maybe you got it at a Hamfest. I think I got this one at a Hamfest. Maybe you got it on Amazon or eBay or any one of a number of different places. And if you have any of these fuses that are like no name, no brand blade fuses, throw them out immediately, because I learned something while I was testing that crowbar circuit that was very alarming to me. Let's go take a look. I decided to move out to the shop to film this one because I'm going to do some experiments here that might melt or smoke something, and I've got a little bit more room, I'm away from the house, and I have a fire extinguisher just in case we need it. So first, let's take a look at how fuses operate and what the purpose of fuses are. One of the misconceptions is people think that fuses are there to protect your electronic equipment, your radio, amplifier, whatever it is. That's not exactly true. The primary purpose of a fuse is actually to protect wiring, to make sure that wires don't melt and catch fire and cause fires. A secondary purpose is they can help protect your radio. If something shorts inside your radio and the fuse blows quick enough, then it will stop the current flow to at least limit the damage. It may not prevent any damage from occurring, and honestly, if something is shorted inside your radio, there's already something that needs to be fixed. But a fuse properly sized can at least help limit the damage to maybe just the component that failed. Let's take a look at how fuses operate and how much current and time it takes to blow or clear a fuse of a given amperage rating. This is the datasheet for Bussmann ATC fuses. On the cover page, we see that these fuses have been tested to meet UL guidelines and are also designed to meet multiple agency standards that define how fuses should operate. All fuses have what's called a characteristic melting curve. This chart shows the curves for Bussmann ATC blade fuses from 1 to 40 amps. The vertical axis is in seconds, and the horizontal axis is in amps. The chart scaling is called log-log. The scales are based on powers of 10, and the distance between numbers gets shorter as you move up or to the right on the chart. Let's look at the 5-amp fuse as an example. At the very top of the chart, we see that the 5-amp fuse would take hours to clear when it's carrying just over 6 amps. As a side note, you may hear me say clear, blow, or open when I'm testing the fuses. Those terms all mean the same thing when talking about fuses. Now we'll follow the 5-amp fuse line down to 10 amps. The fuse should clear in about 0.7 seconds with 10 amps of current. At 20 amps, it should take between 1 and 2/10 of a second to clear the fuse. If we look at the 10-amp fuse, we can see that it should clear in just over a half second with 20 amps of current. Keep these fuses, currents, and opening times in mind as we test the fuses. It's important to understand that this chart shows average melt times, so not every fuse will follow the lines on this chart exactly. An electrical characteristics table in the datasheet tells you what range of times you might be dealing with. The data in this table is listed as a percentage of a fuse's rating.
So the one table applies to all the fuse sizes in this series. You can see that carrying 200% of its rating, a fuse could clear in as little as 0.15 seconds, or it might take as long as 5 seconds. All of this data is specific to Bussmann Eaton ATC fuses. However, there are equivalent tables and data sheets from any manufacturer that complies with agency standards for these types of fuses. And it should all be very similar. I searched for manufacturer names or data sheets for several of the generic fuse offerings. I couldn't find any. There are links in the description to both the Bussmann and Little Fuse data sheets if you're interested. Let's look at the fuses we'll be testing.
Here's a typical fuse assortment that you might find on Amazon or several other online catalogs. And you might see these at a ham fest. I'm pretty sure I bought this set at a ham fest. There's 120 fuses is what it was advertised as. It's got 5, 10, 15, 20, 25, and 30 amp fuses. And I think I paid $10 or $12 for this. So it seemed like a pretty good bargain. This is a pack of Little Fuse fuses. Little Fuse is a brand name that's been around for quite a while, pretty well known. This is a package of 40 fuses, and I just bought this for about 20 bucks at a local auto parts store. And this is a pack of Bussmann fuses, which is owned by Eaton now. Bussmann fuses have also been around for a very long time. They make all different kinds of fuses. And this has got 42 fuses in it. And this was, I think, about 19 bucks at the local Walmart. So what's the difference between all of these? Well, if you take any of them and you put them into a fuse holder, like this one, they're going to conduct just fine. The problem is, if you actually want them to protect anything, that's where the difference is between these different fuses. This is a little test rig I made. It's just a fuse holder for a blade type fuse and an Anderson power pole. So I can plug a fuse into this, and then if I plug the Anderson power pole into my power supply, it will just put the fuse right across the plus and minus as a dead short. So we can test to see how quickly the fuse is going to blow. This is the power supply that we're going to use. And this is a 30 volt, 20 amp power supply. I've got it set for 15.5 volts right now. And you'll see a little CV in the display, which is constant voltage. So I can adjust the voltage up and down. And honestly, the voltage I have it set for doesn't really matter, because when we put the short circuit across it, the voltage is going to go down to 1 volt or less, whatever goes across the fuse. And then it will switch to constant current mode. And I have the current set for maximum right now, so you can't see that because it doesn't show you the setting if there's no current going out. But I have it set for maximum, which should be about 20 amps. So when I put any fuse into this, it's going to put 20 amps across that fuse. I have set up a wood block here so I don't melt my plastic table. I've got the stopwatch set up on my phone so we can watch the time. And I have a 5-amp fuse. I don't know if you can see the 5. It's actually not painted on the fuse. It's embossed in it. And you're going to look at it and hold the fuse just right in the light to actually read the 5. Hopefully I'll have a little picture in here that you can see. So I'm going to take the 5-amp fuse and I'm going to plug it into my test rig. And I'm going to plug this in and start the stopwatch and we'll see what happens. So there we go. And you can see that the power supply went up to 21.3 amps, and it's at about 0.6 volts. And the fuse hasn't blown. So we're running 20 amps through our 5 amp fuse right now. And I've also got this digital thermometer, so we can take a look at what we're getting for temperatures on the fuse. It's already at 101. Now it's at 112. We're up to almost a minute. So we've been running 20 amps through our 5 amp fuse for over a minute now. All right, we're coming up on 2 minutes, and let's see. The temperature of our fuse is 137.6 degrees. And it still hasn't tripped. We're still putting out 20 amps. All right, we're coming up on 3 minutes. And the fuse is now at 156.3 degrees. I'm not sure this is ever going to trip. All right, I think you get the point here. We're going to stop this. All right, I've reset the stopwatch. I'm going to turn off the power supply. We went well over 3 minutes. And this wire is actually pretty warm. And I'm not even going to try to touch the fuse, but this is a 5 amp fuse that has gone for more than 3 minutes with 20 amps running through it. So if you have something small you're trying to protect, I don't think this is going to help you much. We're going to move up a little bit. This is a 10 amp fuse, but this is one of the Bussmann fuses, not one of my cheap no-name fuses. So I'm gonna put that in the holder and I'm gonna turn on the power supply, and it's at 15 volts. And I am going to plug this in. I guess it doesn't matter if I plugged it in the wrong way, except you can't do that with Anderson power poles. So let's see how long this is gonna go. And you didn't even see that move. And I don't know if you saw the flash or not, but this fuse has already blown. So a 10 amp fuse on this 20 amp power supply lasted maybe a tenth of a second. I don't know. We'll see if maybe we can improve the test setup here and see if we can see how long this lasts. I was just curious how long this was actually going to take, so I brought my scope out, and I have the scope hooked up across the fuse so we can see the voltage across the fuse. And we're going to take another 10 amp fuse and connect it up here. I have the power supply turned off right now. So we're going to set this up for a single acquisition, and then we are going to turn on the power supply and see what happens. And the fuse blew, and here you can see where the power supply turned on. Right here, and then it was 100, 200, this is 100 milliseconds per division, 100, 200, 350 milliseconds, so less than half a second and the fuse blew. Big difference, and this is a 10 amp fuse with 20 amps going across it instead of the 5 amp fuse. I didn't show you in the video, but I tested a bunch of the brand name fuses, both the Little Fuse and the Bussmann fuses. And I tested the 5 amp, 10 amp, and even the 15 amp fuses. And the 15-amp fuses cleared in less than 10 seconds with 20 amps going through them. So all of these fuses worked as I would expect them to work. And the 5-amp fuses, the no-name ones, I tested several of those. They all behaved the same way. And the one that you saw in the video, I had actually tested that exact fuse multiple times, running it at 20 amps for 2 and 3 minutes. So that fuse was even pre-stressed by quite a bit, and it still didn't clear with 20 amps going through it. Based on the behavior that I saw with the 5-amp ones, I didn't see any point in trying the bigger fuses. The bottom line is, if you want to protect your QRP, especially equipment, or any other smaller equipment, stick with the brand name fuses. And even the larger ones, although I couldn't test them, I suspect that the 20 amp fuses are not going to clear at 40 amps. I don't know, maybe I'll get a bigger power supply one of these days and I'll be able to try that. Anyway, that's all I've got for this time. By the way, if you want one of these t-shirts, there's a link in the description where you can get them. And also there's a link on my website where you can get the shirts if you're interested in those. If you liked this video, I'd appreciate it if you'd make a click on that like button. And if you like the channel, please consider subscribing and then click the bell icon so that you'll get notified when new videos come out. As always, thanks for watching. I'm Tom, WA2IVD, and this is Ham Radio A to Z.